Nice. Today, my little gamers, we are, again, we've just spoken to Kate, she wants to be left alone, we took a picture of that squirrel, and we are now going to get the flash drive back for Warren, because he wants it, and he's apparently looking cool in the parking lot, waiting for us, so let's go. Guys, okay, so... Move, bitch.
Oh,
get
look,
out of the way.
It's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell. What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your wave hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled. Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Hold that pose. So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh, yes, Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way.
I would go fuck my own selfie, but it ain't that good. Okay, so... Hello, Samuel!
I could crank the sprinkler up and give Victoria and her clones incentive to...
Samuel.
There goes Samuel da Vinci to paint the window.
Samuel da Vinci, that's such a gay name. Okay, so... We'll crank up the sprinklers.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah. Oh, wait, hang on.
Water on my cashmere? Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Hang on, I think I screwed up. Yeah, I screwed up. Okay, right, hang on. Sorry, guys. There you go. Okay. Time travel, rewind, rewind. Time travel, rewind, rewind. 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 Now, I have to rewind all the way back. Yeah, all the way back.
No.
Click before time, you're good. Boop.
Okay, let's see if this works.
Oh, look at him. He's like, I hate my job. Why does everyone think I'm weird? I'm only, like, just looking after everyone in a weird, creepy way. Skip all that. Oh no, my cashmere!
Victoria?
Oh, Samuel, sorry. Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo.
Nice, bro.
Mm-hmm. Hold on. Bitch, we'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I drive.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches.
Sweet.
Hi, Kate.
Hey, Max.
How did you like class today?
I don't remember. I guess I don't care about much of anything today.
Is there anything...
Max, I'd like to be alone, if you don't mind. I'm sorry.
Oh, Kate still doesn't want to speak to us. I would have thought she would have reacted to Victoria getting dumped on! But no, yeah, what I was gonna say was, because I didn't want to interrupt the dialogue, was that, Max could have killed Victoria. Like, if Victoria was literally standing right under the paint, and the paint can just, like, hit her. Like, oh my god. It would have been just like, oh my cashmere. It would have been shit. We need to call an ambulance. Okay, now let's talk to her. Ooh, I like that bag. It's a cute bag. Probably need
it. Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I know I said I was going to do the opposite way I did in my ever playthrough, but I can't make fun of Victoria. She's just hiding stuff because you know how bitches are like. They're like, but she's just insecure.
I am sorry. That's an awesome cashmere coat.
It was. But there'll be another.
Well, you always seem to know how to pick the right outfits.
I do have some talent. Mr. Jefferson told me.
I've seen your pictures. You have a great eye. Richard Avedon-esque.
He's one of my heroes. Thanks, Max.
I hope those sluts get me a towel before they hang a sign on me.
You deserve a better shot. Sorry about blocking you and the go fuck your selfie.
That was mean, but pretty funny.
Just one of those days, you know?
I know exactly what you mean, Victoria. I'll see you later.
Au revoir.
See? She gets rid of your photo.
Victoria
and this
probably
also
played
helps
me.
That,
I should have played her.
Oh, shut up.
Better get to my room before I find Warren.
But yeah, so she obviously gets rid of the photo and you're slightly on good, better terms. What else I think helps is that Victoria is quite close with Nathan. And if you're bitchy to Victoria, Nathan will like take your ass because, you know, it's like, yo, you don't mess with my hood.
Victoria is going to be pissed we took so long.
Well, you should just grab some towels. Jesus Christ, how long does it take to grab some towels? Okay. Oh yeah, let's go have a look at all the slates that people do. Okay, so this Taylor is a slave. Hang on.
Welcome to Black Hill.
Taylor, yep. Taylor is a slave, right? And we got Stella. Requiem. Okay, Stella. Juliet, read this week's edition of the Blackwell Totem?
Juliet, extreme reporter.
Seriously? Oh, seriously, who cares? And then, Stomp
Dana's
and Bigfoot.
Dana's still a cheerleader at heart.
Dana's cheerleaders. And then... I thought that looks like a skeleton for a minute. It's like, what? This is...
Okay, this is just mean and stupid.
Yeah, that's, Kate. We'll bang for Jesus. Ha ha ha. Lol. Nah. Peace. That's Taylor's. I wish you could go in. Be the change... Be the change you wisely you wish to see. Yeah, be the change you wish to see by Gandhi. Gotta have a Gandhi quote there.
Pie. Warren should be all over Brooke. They're perfect for each other.
Oh, you just got friends in there.
How sad. I didn't write anything. I have nothing to say.
Oh, fuck off. Just draw another main character. Just be like, blah, blah, blah. Was I right?
Wow. Obvious but true.
You're like literally screaming, I'm insecure! I'm an insecure hipster!
Home sweet home. My favorite cocoon.
Oh, guess what we're gonna do, guys? Let's play the guitar! I'm at a private school with a scholarship. And I do some photographs. Do 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 do. I'm secretly hiding the fact I'm gay, or at least bisexual. Boo. Boom. And that was my jam. Max Caulfield, the story of my life. Ooh, I have a text. Hi, honey. Your principal sent me an email saying that he was concerned about your attitude and behavior, that you are not fitting in well and hiding in your dorm. I know it's hard to be away from home, even if you are all grown up now, but you are there to change the world with your camera. Please call me soon to chat. We miss you. XOXXO, mommy. Fucking Principal Wells. Is that my behavior not fitting in? I don't conform to society. I'm Max Caulfield. I don't conform. I didn't lie down. That's literally me. Like,
it feels so nice to just relax.
I know.
This day has been so damn bizarre, and it feels like it has gone on forever. Maybe I'll just wake up now and find out I was dreaming all of this. Or like Poe said, a dream within a dream.
But that's literally like me. I get home, and she's like, bed. Night-night. Anyway, apart from that, let's just go get his flash drive. Because we could be all in here all day, just like, looking around. There's some photos.
That's the only tourist picture I let them take of me at the Space Needle. That was a good hockey game, and a great fight. Man, Kristen and Fernando were so drunk hanging on the Fremont Troll.
Lol. Draw.
Max and Chloe, best friends forever. Who even says that anymore? I'm going to have to call Chloe eventually and find out what she'll say. The longer I wait, the worse it'll be. Idiot.
Hint, hint. Hint, hint. It's like hinting at you. Let's just put the hi-fi on. Why not?
Daniel has so much talent.
Aw, look at my peach.
I hope nobody hates on it just because it's me. I am so addicted to this site. Look at these vintage beauties. Lauren makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real friend here.
Warren Graham, Warren G at Blackwell Academy. Max, thanks for your email and copy of Jefferson's class notes. Now I shall never stop sending you messages of gratitude. I also have a rather... I'm sorry, I can't say... eclectic? I am sorry, guys. I can't read these for today. Rather, a static collection of TV cults, classics, and fucked up films on a fat flash drive. I'm sorry. I literally can't read this writing. If you ever want to check them out, thanks again for the help. I'm a scientist more than an artist. Now, can you quickly explain to me how a camera works? Be seeing you, Warren G. Speaking of the flash drive, where is the flash drive? I swear!
There's my poor laptop begging me to check in. Lauren makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real... Looks like Dana left me a
Poster note. Hey girl, I borrowed your drive so I can watch some flicks while I study. If you need it back, just drop it down in my room.
Great. That's fine. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room.
You can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot in there.
Ooh. Juliet got some beef with
Welcome
Dana.
To the real drama queens of Blackwell.
So stupid.
Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh, yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
You are ridiculous.
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
Ouch. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Juliet Watson.
Juliet Watson. Duh.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do. Just because I don't talk a lot doesn't mean I don't care. So, how did you find out about them?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext. And Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything. But I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in her room.
On my way. See, normally you would have to go back and say the right name, but I just had a lucky guess. Clothes, shoes, TV.
I bet Victoria put Juliet on her shit list after this article.
Is the Vortex Club a cult? One of Blackwell's Academy's most durable and influential social groups, the Vortex Club, started in the neon 1980s as a new wave rebellion against the yuppie forces of the Renegade era. Imagine a time when computer nerds were dumped into garbage cans and blue hair was a cause for expulsion and even violence. Male students who wore earrings were bullied and beaten. Now every football player has two or three exotic piercings. So the Vortex Club was originally a haven from the peer pressure that every generation experiences. How ironic that then that the revolutionary roots of social misfits has become what some students claim is an elusive cult. Or is this just envy at one of the Blackwell's most successful organizations? We tried to interview Vortex Club member Victoria Chase, but she refused to comment and even tried to stop this story from publication. Dun dun dun, so she was bitchy. Tablet.
Is she going to get a 3D printer for her dorm room? Maybe I will join her posse.
So I will join the posse for the 3D printer?
Yes, I get it. Enter the Vortex Club.
No.
No.
Okay, it's on the emails.
I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. And for this nice shot. Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
Okay, it is... Victoria Chase to Taylor. Victoria Chase to Taylor. Bitch down! Taylor, so sad to inform you that I totally punked Juliet and Dana just now. All I had to do was mention to Juliet that I saw a nasty sex from Dana on Zach's phone. Dumbass believed me, and so I expected there to be a dorm rampage soon. Juliet deserves this for slutting Zach away from me. As for Dana, who gives a shit? Get out your popcorn, XXVC. Ooh. This?
Ouch. At least she puts her photographs out there. Unlike me.
Dear Miss Chase, thank you for your submission to the Croft Gallery. Unfortunately, your work is not compatible with our mission statement. We appreciate your effort and wish you success in future endeavors. Aww. Yeah, you messed... Okay, oh yeah, I remember.
Let's play a little photo Tetris and leave Victoria a message. Let's move this here. And this one there. A pattern is emerging.
Take a photo. But we're not gonna be that mean, so we're gonna rewind. I just wanted a picture. And it's like no one was here. I just remembered there's a quick picture in my room, so. Selfie! Mirror selfie! That's literally like photo inception. A photo, taking a photo of a photo. Okay, let's go back to Juliet. I keep pressing this wrong beep. Oh, I'm sorry, guys.
Leave me alone, Max. Get a clue. I'm not letting her out until she tells the truth. Leave me alone, Max. Get
oh,
a clue.
Shit, I'm meant to bring it on me. Damn it, I forgot. Oh, wrong. Wrong button. Print email, there you go. I knew I was meant to do something.
This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
Hey guys, it's been a long day. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Juliet, read this.
Of course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Almost done. Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren.
Yeah! See, she's like a massive cheerleader. Go, Bigfoot! Now let's go snooping around Dana's room. Selfie, selfie! Hey!
Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Poor Juliet gets her rage on. I hope she doesn't kill Victoria.
Zachary should worry, too. As if I'd let that ego-cased jockstrap touch me. But I bet Victoria would be all over that action. Or has been. Max, you're smart to be a loner here. Though Warren obviously likes hanging with you.
He's a good guy. A geek like me.
You saw the files in his flash drive. Tons of crazy shit. Films I've never even heard of. And in a special folder called Max.
Yeah, okay. I gotcha.
Are you blushing? Go ahead and grab the flash drive whenever.
Sure, I'm just gonna be snooping around.
This is both sad and pathetic.
Dana, I suck at writing, but I thought I should write to distance so you might not hate my dumb ass forever. I know I act like a tough jock around everybody, but I never had to act around you. I'm not the kind of man you deserve. You saw how I pushed out. If you need any money, let me know. Logan. Lol.
It would be a cool sticker without the words.
If that's a Vortex Club sticker. Cheerleader outfit. Ooh, what's this? Oh. Oh.
Oh, Max, that's mine. Thank you. You're not helpful. You're just nosy. I think you better go.
Rewind time, rewind time.
Nice,
we were never,
Max.
We were never nosy. Rewind
so
time.
So damn nosy again.
Re.
But I could rewind and make it up to her.
Okay, then we go and speak.
Hey, Dana.
I heard a
Dana,
rumor.
I'm not trying to be nosy, but I heard a rumor about you.
What? Who told you I was pregnant?
Nobody important. They just acted like it was bullshit. I just wanted you to know.
It's like a goddamn reality show around here. Can you keep a secret, Max?
Yes. You're pregnant? No, of course.
Of course.
I was pregnant. Was.
Oh. What about the other?
Deadbeat Dad? You can catch him on the 40-yard line this Friday.
And it's not Zachary.
Sorry to pry. It's not my business. And I won't be at the game Friday. Not much school spirit, I guess.
I like your spirit, Max. Anyway, you better get that flash drive so Warren has an excuse to bug you.
We know that the daddy baby was Logan, because it's like if you need any money.
Must protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
Right.
Of course a popular cheerleader like Dana would have a million friends. It's so fascinating to get a peek into Dana's social media world. And yes, Max, so terribly wrong.
I'm Julia. Hey girl, thanks for the party favors. Trevor, what up Dana? Justin coach locked with Super Mario. If you want to come over, we can blaze and play or go for a walk. Let me know. I'll be here. Still here. Hello? Okay. Let's take this flash drive.
I better make sure everything is still in there.
Weird science homework.
I think Warren forgot to hide the Party Buster folder.
Greatest
not
TV
that I would open it
ever.
No matter how tempting.
I
have my self-respect.
Muzak, randoms, not downloaded. The Party Buster, unholy obscenities, and Max. Not a stalker whatsoever. Okay, bye-bye. Actually, I want to see if what happens when you take the pregnancy.
Max, that's mine. Thank you. You're not helpful. You're...
Oh, nice, she just
Max.
Says the same
you
thing.
You hurt her
okay.
feelings by being so damn nosy again. But I could rewind and make it up to her. Hey, Dana.
Oh. I thought we were...
Dana.
What?
Nobody... It's like a... Of course. Sorry to...
No, no, no. Okay. Didn't realize it went all the way back.
Now I feel too wiped out to leave.
Okay, let's go and... Oh, God. I don't mind waiting out here forever. I love this parking lot. I can count all the cars. The more I text, the longer I take. On my way. Bye! God, sounds like my boyfriend. He's like, where are you? I've been waiting for 5 minutes. To be fair, he has been waiting quite a long time.
Fuck this shit!
Ow!
Wait, I gotta do that again.
I better rewind.
Whoop!
Fuck this shit!
Whoop!
This shit. 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 This shit. Shit. This shit. This shit.
Ow! Ow!
Shit. This shit. This shit.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
Let's take a photo. Cool. And I got a text from Juliet. Julia, Victoria, I mean. BTW, thanks, but we're not friends. Yeah, that's fine, but I wasn't asking to be friends, God.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Intervene, because he's an asshole.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Sure.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate.
He caught you. See? You gotta love Kate.
I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me.
Officer David Dickhead.
Maybe I should rewind?
Nah. We are going to fight against the government and authority. Oh yeah, I forgot to finish my story with you guys. Yeah, last time I said about the dabbing and about the meme and the dance. Yeah, okay, so last Saturday,
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
I know, Max, that's, yes. But yeah, last Saturday we were, I organised a cosplay picnic with some friends. And if you guys don't know what cosplay is, do you even internet? But at the same time, it's, oh, missed the photo. But yeah, basically it's cosplay, you know, dress up as anime characters or any characters you want from films, TV shows, or your own characters. And, but yeah, we all dressed up in Bristol and in the park, and we had a picnic, and we all enjoyed ourselves. And this kid, he dabbed so hard, he dislocated his leg. And I'm not even like, oh, he dislocated. No, like, literally, his knee was on the other side. Like, you know, your knee's, like, in the middle. It was, like, so far right, it was really, and he was in so much pain.
I have to go find Ron and give him
so
back
we had to call
drive.
An ambulance. Took about 20 minutes, so we called them again, because I think they thought it was a joke or something, and then they finally arrived and went, oh shit, yeah. And oh god, he was on the morphine.
It's not a dirty window unless somebody writes clean me on it.
Yeah. So, message of the day, kids. Dab safe and responsibly.
I could use this picture for a series on Arcadia Bay lots.
I'm so dirty. Let's go see Warren.
Yo, Max, check it out. What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
Friend zoned.
No problem.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really?
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
Really?
You can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hardcore. So you must use a computer to draw?
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck. I'll let you know.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Really?
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
No fucking way will I watch that. My mind is twisted enough.
I laughed my ass off.
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white. Plus, no, babes with breasts.
Yeah. Don't mind beat us your too. Sensitive ass down.
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
Tell me everything, you darkest secret.
This is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you saw, now. Answer
nothing
me,
but a butterfly.
Bitch. You're full of shit. I'd respect you more if you told me the truth.
I don't need your respect.
You're clueless. You have no idea who I am or what I can do.
Actually, I have a pretty good idea of who you are.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Boom, headshot.
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore
right
in the bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
No! No, I got this!
Get in, Max!
Now
get
she's like,
your punk
do
asses
I love
out
the
of there now!
Or do
Don't
I
even try to run!
Penis?
Nobody! Nobody!
Anyway, you see what I mean? Like, he's... If I reported him to
Man,
Principal Wells, he
Nathan
would have been
Prescott
a lot more
is
aggressive.
Messed
like,
up.
I'm gonna
and
fucking
dangerous.
Kill you.
This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe.
Chloe,
after 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Only for Mark Jefferson. He was a pretty famous photographer in the 90s. I've always loved his work.
Those that can't do, teach. I'm glad you found a good reason to come back.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Oh, the lighting's so pretty.
Cereal?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific, tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max. Come on in. Don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
It's a little birdie.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-führer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
What you smoking?
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
Party all night? I don't feel grown-up. Not much. Party all night.
Party all night.
Not Little Miss Wallflower. I bet you've never even been to a party.
Oh, right. I went to your birthday blowout.
Max, you were 12 years old. That's sad. You should stick to taking photos.
No. Chains me. Let's just get back.
So tell me.
I take photos.
I take photos. Of me, the world, everything. It may sound sad, but I have a blast.
It doesn't sound that sad.
I'm happiest when I've got a great image in my lens. I'm not lonely, not afraid.
Now that's more inspiring. I don't feel so totally hopeless.
Okay, let's open the... If we search the box, we break something. We're not going to break anything. Search the bag.
And it reeks like dirty laundry. Gross.
Look.
This postcard is from Rachel Ember.
Miss you, wish you were here. So, from that thing, if you guys haven't guessed already, Chloe and Rachel... our best buds. Paper.
Damn, Chloe does need a lot of money to get out of Arcadia.
Lol. Search this.
Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close.
Were, as in, daddy's dead. She's got daddy issues. Everybody lies, no exception. There's a TV, power strip, let's switch it on. Funky lights. Now we just need to find a CD.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Ember. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot, even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch.
But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than that.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now? Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
Oh, this is a flashback to Youth. Our super secret closet lair. Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height. Nothing but junk in this suitcase. Nope. Someone locked it from the other side. Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days. I'd love to go to Paris, too. At this rate, they'll be lucky to get to Portland. Joy still works at Tuwell's Diner. Best damn burgers in Arcadia. I better get one soon. I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. Yum, that looks tasty. I do miss Joyce's cooking. I should be able to find the tools I need here. These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that camera. I wonder what's in those files up there. Shit! Butterfingers! Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For real? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this? A map of Blackwell Academy. I wonder why. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway. Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get? Chloe's stepdad is a veteran and a security guard? He must really hate her. One of these guns is missing. I hope Chloe's stepdad isn't packing heat. Yes! Score! Boom! Precision screwdrivers. Except, I can't reach them. That does not look stable. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Let's see. The tools are stuck, out of reach, and no way in hell to get them. Brilliant, Max. Brilliant. Man, I should have done that before they fell. Yes, you have mad skills, Max. I've got the tools. I should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks.
Freaks? I think she's fine just blazing. I would too, so... Fixing a camera, fixing a camera. This is Max Schofield fixing a camera.
So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah. I just took them today.
Let me see. Wait. I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there, hiding in the corner.
Damn, you're a ninja.
A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
Not at all. Your hair and clothes are so different.
I hope so. I'm sure this is all so weird to you after coming back.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit.
There is no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
No, I didn't know what to do.
I don't blame you. That's some intense shit.
Maybe I should go to the principal.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
Seriously, I didn't blab to anybody. Promise.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max. I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Woo! Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that phony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera. This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max.
Yo, turn it off. Turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on.
It's not even punk, to be honest.
Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just... Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now. Please.
1 second. My bra is... Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. You're so friggin' paranoid.
Yeah, combat will do that to you. One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh, God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh, yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order. Whose is it?
Stop treating me and my mom like we're your family platoon.
Hey, leave Joyce out of this.
I wish you'd leave Joyce, like now.
Chloe, I'm sorry. I care about your mother, and you just keep pushing me.
Don't touch me again, asshole. That's the last time. Or I'll bring the cops in here so fast.
You're not that dumb.
I'd be smart to have you busted.
Chloe, someday you'll grow up.
Hey, you okay?
Welcome to the real step douches of Arcadia Bay.
I'm sorry.
For what? He would have been a bigger dick if he caught you in here.
That's hard to believe.
Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can go to in this hick hole.
David was such a mean bastard to Chloe. What if I had stepped up to help?
We'll go out through the window. Seeing step dick is not on the agenda.
Okay, let's go. So yeah, I stepped in last time and it's more David hates you more. So he does like kind of like you a bit more, but she did say stay out, so. We're almost to the end of episode one.
I haven't been here in forever, so why do I feel like I was just here? Whoa, this is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today.
Okay, there's a picture.
I got you.
Okay. Cool, let's go see Chloe by the lighthouse. The notorious pretty lighthouse. Oh god.
Birds are
it's
so
Warren.
Lucky. They can always
dun 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 dun. Earth to Max, your white knight Warren is here. I know you were worried about me. I owe you. Thanks for today. I'll call back later, okay? I swear. No problem. And you still have to tell me your big secret. Okay. He's literally... Your white knight Warren is here. Literally saying, marry
escape.
Me. Marry me. Literally, every time Warren comes, it should be dun 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 dun. That's his theme. The Jaws theme is like dun 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 dun. Oh,
looks like the youth of Arcadia Bay still come up here to party. I never made it.
Trust no one. No monkey thing. Sadly, you can't go in the lighthouse. I wish you could go in the lighthouse. Look at the pretty ones. The Arcadia Bay is really nice. Take a photo of Chloe. Actually, a nice photo, this one. See, why can't that be the everyday hero? Of just someone... Because you can tell with Chloe that she's not really loving life. It's like with suicide, it's just like... Someone who fights every day to just keep going. Because they know somehow it'll get better or something, so that could be an everyday.
Sure you don't want to be alone?
Sit down if you want.
Are you pissed at me?
I just wanted some backup.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
Freaked out on Kate.
He freaked out on poor Kate Marsh today.
I know her. She's cool. Only that prick would bully her.
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
You know, I wanted to, but... I realized I have enough mystery in my life.
I'd like to find out. I bet he's got some serious porn in there. Good thing you didn't look. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
What's Nathan's secret?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
What?
I met him in some shithole bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe. Now.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
How much do you owe?
$3,000 plus interest. And before I could get a chunk of that from Nathan, he dosed my drink with some shit.
God, Chloe. I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
Wow. Okay. I am so furious. That is fucked up.
I am so furious, I can't even speak. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
He's still dangerous. Let's call the police. No, don't call the police.
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Good thing you didn't tell anyone. Nathan Prescott better watch his back now.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
Destiny.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max. This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved. I'd like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass.
Now! I'm like this in America.
tornado is back! Straight for the town. Chloe, you're here. I'm back. Oh my lord, this is real. It's real. Oh man, this sucks.
Max, what's going on? You totally blacked out.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years, which is so.
No, I saw it. I could actually feel the electricity in the air.
Come on, take a breath, okay?
Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something hardcore.
Talk to me, Max.
I had this same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But high, right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game. People don't have those powers, Max.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
You need to get high. It's been a hell insane fucking day. What the hell is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Climate change. Or a storm is coming.
Max, start from the beginning. Tell me everything.
Okay, see you next time, guys. And thank you for being part of LikkleMel Gaming. Okay, Ghibli out.